In this video, we will build realistic fabric shaders for curtains. For this, we will first talk about geometry differences, then learn how to set up thin and thick curtains, and finally implement translucency for a more photorealistic appearance. All right, so this one here would be our starting point. As you can see, we have a nice looking interior scene with a big window, but we don't really have any curtains in front of the window for now. That's what we're gonna do in this tutorial in here. The scene itself is set up quite simple, and if you want to know the lighting setup for this, you can check out a tutorial that I did that deals with interior lighting, and that should help you getting a similar starting point. Or if you want, you can also download all of my scene files on my Patreon and also watch a whole course on car rendering and find lots of other additional goodies. But now, without any further ado, let's start to set up our curtains. So for this, let's just zoom into our room here and let's unhide some geometry which I prepared already. You can see we have two different curtains appearing in our room. We have two different geometries. We have this more thinner curtain here, which is directly in front of the window. And then we have this more thicker greenish curtain here, and we're going to be doing the shader for both of them. Let's first check out here the geometry setup for our curtains, and you will notice we have two different types of setup. So here for the thin curtains, we don't have any thickness. You can see we have this razor sharp edge. And for our thicker greenish curtains, we have some thickness in here. So the curtain has some actual volume. And that's something that's important for the shading setup, because the setup is then going to be slightly different. So that's something you have to check, what kind of geometry you use for your curtains, and then just apply the correct shading setup depending on your use case. For now, let's just hide this thicker curtain and let's only work on this more thinner and almost transparent curtain for now. So let's now work on the shader for our curtain. At the moment, we just have this standard vray material here applied to our curtain that has this gray diffuse color for now. So let's first change that. Let's make this here more bright, for example, almost white. And I want to give this here a slightly coolish color tint, so a little bit of bluish tint in here to just have a bit more contrast between our curtain and our wall in here. So my next step would be normally to introduce some kind of reflection to the shader, but for these type of materials, these fabrics which are very soft, normally reflections, they don't really give you much benefit apart from increasing your render time. So instead, we're going to be using here the sheen effects. So in order to make them visible, let's just hide here our diffuse color. I will copy this color and then just put this back to black. And now if we start to increase here our sheen effects to white, you can slowly start to see that there's something happening here. What you have to normally do is to decrease here the glossiness. So let's just put this to 0.4 in this case. And you can see we have something that looks like a reflection without really adding a lot of additional render time, and makes this here quite efficient. Now we can just bring back here our diffuse color by just pasting this back in again. Then we have quite a nice base for our shader. So now let's introduce the most important aspect of our shader, and that is the translucency. Because at the moment here, our curtain is completely solid. It doesn't allow any light to pass through. And this way it looks very, very thick, and it makes also our room here extremely dark. So for this, let's enable the subsurface scattering here and the translucency. And once we enable this, you will see there's nothing really happening. The reason for that is that our geometry here doesn't really have any thickness, as I described earlier. So in these kind of situations, you have to enable the thin-walled mode here. And now you can see that we allow the sunlight that comes in from the window to pass through here our curtain. And by this way, it shows up on the backside of our curtain as well, and also illuminates our room here quite nicely. So now with the SSS amount value in here, you can define the amount of translucency. So if I put this all the way to zero, you can see then we have no translucency at all anymore. What I normally like to do is to do like a in-between. So we have a 0.5 here. And I think like this, we can achieve quite a good balance in here. So now we have the situation that our curtain is translucent, so you can see the sunlight is visible on the backside of the curtain, but it's not really transparent. So as you can see here, for example, on the floor, you'd expect that the sun basically continues here on the floor, But at the moment, it's still completely blocked. And for this, we will need to enable transparency. So for this, let's open our maps. And then in the opacity slot, let's just put a simple vray bitmap inside. And I have this opacity map here. And once we add this, you can see that now we have a much better effect because if you check the lighting channel, we have the sunlight, which is scattering through our curtain. But at the same time, it's also here visible on our floor. And that's, I think, much more the effect that we were looking for. So now the scaling, of course, is much too big. So let's just put a simple vray UVW randomizer. And let's set this here to stochastic tiling. And then let's disable the UV rotation. And now we can just increase here the tiling, for example, to something like 15. And then you can see we have a much nicer result. We can still see a little bit of the texture here of our fabric. We have this nice transparency here. We can see what's happening behind the window. But as said, at the same time, we have this kind of like sunlight, which is scattered on the backside of our curtain. And I think like this, it looks already quite nice and quite realistic. Now, if we want to further enhance this, we can go up here into our shader. And let's just put here our opacity into a simple composite so that here our map is at the base of our composite. And we can add a new layer, and I will add a new texture, which I already copied here earlier. And I will just show you this one here. It's basically just a simple gradient here with the interpolation type set to solid. And you can see that it masks out here the top and the bottom of our curtain. And that's an effect that oftentimes happens when you have the curtain here wrapped around itself. You kind of get this thicker curtain here at the top and at the bottom. And now we would just need to go inside and switch this mode here to screen. And now you can see we have an even nicer effect where the top and the bottom is less transparent or not transparent at all. And we have also this kind of more interesting shadow here on the floor. So that's as far as I want to push it now for the thin curtain. And in the next step, let's check out how we can set up the shader for our thicker curtain and then see the final result of both of our curtains together. So here I only show our thick curtain for now so that we don't get distracted with our thin curtain. And this one uses just this simple V-Ray material for now that at the moment just has this greenish diffused color. So as a first step, we can enable here our sheen effects again. Let's just put this all the way to white. And you can see we can get this kind of like soft appearance here on the edges already. We can lower here our glossiness, maybe to something like 0.6. And I think like this, the curtain looks even more soft with this kind of like velvety highlight here on the edges. And now instead of a simple color, let's just use a V-Ray bitmap. Let's just load this pattern in here so that we can get some nicer result. So now we can also play with translucency. And in this case, the workflow is slightly different because as said, this object here has some thickness. So it's not just a single sided polygon as was the thin curtain. But as said, this one here is a full volume. So now if we choose the translucency to be subsurface scattering, then you can notice several things. So first of all, we didn't have to enable the thin walled option here to get some effect because as said, our geometry here uses some thickness. So this one here has to be disabled. And now we have a big change, and that's because here the subsurface scattering amount is set to 1, so 100%, and the subsurface scattering color is set to white. So let's just copy here our diffuse color also in the subsurface scattering color. And then let's just put the amount to 0.5 to mix between our diffuse contribution and our translucency. And now you can see we have also the sunlight being able to pass through our curtain. You can also see that because we have some thickness here in our geometry, the shadow automatically gets adjusted. So depending on the scale, for example, if I use a much higher scale like 5 centimeters, then the light is even able to pass through our surface here. You can see these shadows are brightened up, contrary to the thin curtains where we enable this thin walled option. where here our shadows were not really affected. So in this case, if you have some thickness in your geometry, this has an additional advantage. So you don't need to enable transparency necessarily in order to have your shadows here affected. So overall now I feel this curtain here looks way too thin. And for this we can use several options. Either we can decrease here our scaling, or we can decrease our bounce. Let's just put them on to 0.1 for example. And then like this, only a little bit of sunlight is able to pass through our curtains. But you can see we get a quite nice effect here in the shadows, where the shadows are a little bit brighter compared to the shadows here from our window frames. So I think like this, for a thicker curtain, it's quite balanced now. So now let's check out our final result. You can see we have these two curtains, one which is very thin and transparent, so we can see quite nicely through the curtain and it's affected heavily by the sunlight and only has a very faint shadow here on the floor. And then we have our thicker curtain, which basically is quite opaque. It doesn't let a lot of light through. And we just have this barely brightened up shadow here on the side. And I think with these two types of curtains, you can basically replicate 99% of all curtains that you might need in your scenes. And I hope you learned something new while watching this video. As usual, if you want to download the scene files and try it out by yourself, you can check out my Patreon. You can also see a whole course on car rendering and find lots of other additional goodies over there. So check that out if that's interesting for you. Otherwise, see you next tutorial. Take care and see you soon.